joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room and heaven and nature sing. And
well, good morning, everybody. Okay, now that let's try that one more time. I'm sure the brisk air this morning helped to wake you up. So let's try it again. Good morning. Are you excited about what this morning has available for us this morning? That was really lame. Should I try that again? Are you excited about this morning?
Yes.
Are you excited to be in God's house this morning?
Yes.
All right. And are you excited to hear the Christmas story in a unique way? Good. All right. Well, that's what we're going to have this morning. Before we dive into this morning's activities, I just want to give you a couple quick announcements. Ladies, hopefully you received one of these invitations as you walked in. If you didn't, we have them at the usher's table. After the service, we invite you to pick them up. What this basically is, we are launching a new women's ministry opportunity. It's going to be Monday evenings, 7 o'clock. And on here, you're going to see the next three studies outlined for you. You're welcome to slide into one, two, or all three of them. But again, more details on this and a sign-up sheet will be available to you in the lobby so you can sign up and learn more information about connecting as gals in this place and through this ministry. Guys, I want you also to know, if you've missed out on the beginning of our men's ministry, there's a fabulous time to slide into it coming up Wednesday morning, January the 9th. Okay, so Wednesday, January the 9th, the doors open at 5:45, and you're going to slide in with a group of guys that have been gathering, but it'll be fresh and new because we're starting the last half of this, which you will not feel like you've missed out on the first half. We've been dealing with some stuff. Now we're starting a new journey starting January the 9th, Wednesday mornings, 5:45, and we usually can slide out of there about 7:15 or 7:30 if you want to stay a little longer, okay? Men, women, we'd love to have you join us for either the men's or women's ministry opportunities here going on at Timberline. Now, something that's become a tradition here at Timberline is called our five-minute community connection. We have realized we are a relational bunch of people, and we want no one to walk out of this place not feeling the love of the Lord to you, and so we have reserved 5 minutes this morning to meet the folks around. It's not 30 seconds, it's not a minute, and I know for the introverts, this is the most painful part of the morning, right? Amen. Okay, but for the extroverts, how do you feel? Oh, come on, extroverts, come on. Try that one more time. Okay, there you go. So, introverts are hiding in their chairs at this moment. Here's what we do. For the next 5 minutes, we invite everyone just to get up. If you're able to work your way around the worship center, meet somebody you have maybe never met before you connect with others that you do know. We reserve the next 5 minutes for that. So I'll rudely interrupt you in about 5 minutes. Right about the time you're getting into a good conversation, I'm going to be interrupting you. All right, ready? So let's have everybody stand. Look around and go, who don't I know? And have a great time connecting this morning.
Sell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Sell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. When I was a seeker, I sought both night and day. I asked the Lord to help me, and He showed me.
All right, who wants to keep doing this for the next hour? All right, we'll keep the lights in the house going. We'll leave the lights up a little bit. As you find your way, we thought it only appropriate to sing a couple of favorite Christmas songs together. So we've asked Amy if she would lead us in a time of singing this morning. So if you will watch Amy, the words will be on the screen. And we just invite everybody, it seems only appropriate to stand while we sing these, right? So let's stand together and enjoy this time of worship.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord, late in time behold him come, offspring of the Virgin's womb. Wild in flesh the Godhead see, hail the incarnate deity, pleased as man with men to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace, hail the Son of Righteousness, light and life to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lays his glory by, born that man no more may die, born to raise the sons of earth, born to give them second birth. To the world the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let men their souls employ. While fields and floods, rocks, hills, and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love.
You may be seated.
All right, let's keep things moving here. We're auditioning for the angel. Who's next? Hello. I think I'm next. I'm here for my audition.
Great. Start with telling me a little bit about yourself before you read.
Well, you may not believe this, but my name actually is Angel. I know. I've heard them all over the years with a name like that.
I bet you have. So what made you want to audition for the role of the angel for the live nativity?
Well, I am an actress, and a pretty good one, so I've been told.
I see.
Well, maybe you haven't had a chance to take a look at the headshot that I attached to my audition application, but I also was Maria in West Side Story and Phantom in Phantom of the Opera.
You played the Phantom?
Well, I do have to admit, maybe they were just a little bit short on men that summer, but I never backed down from a challenge. Well, maybe my rendition was just a little bit more soprano than baritone, though.
You sound more than qualified.
Well, I would hope so. I have literally held every single role in the live nativity, except my name, the Angel. I've even been Mary twice. I think it's about time.
Perfect. So go ahead and grab the script and read the angel's lines for me.
Joseph, son of David, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for
go ahead and stop for a minute, please.
Excuse me?
You do realize this isn't a musical. You're singing the script.
Well, my bad. I just kind of thought maybe you wanted me to jazz it up a little bit.
A virgin who is with child is pretty jazzed up already, don't you think?
Well, maybe that's true, but I could be just a little bit used to the story the way that it is. My bad.
Go ahead and take another shot at it, please.
Okay. Joseph, son of David, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit.
You read that passage really well. I'm wondering if next time we could do it just a little bit more.
You know, I actually think I'm going to have to interrupt you. I just had this crazy, oh wow moment. I mean, the angel had the biggest announcement ever made. I mean, of all the announcements ever made on the entire planet, this has got to be the biggest. It's like the angel was the first instant messenger. I mean, it's like she IM'd Mary, Joseph, and the shepherds.
Okay, I can go with that. Never really thought of it that way. Instant messenger. Okay, why don't you read it again for me?
I actually think maybe I'm gonna pass. I don't think there's any amount of my method acting that's really gonna help bring this role to life, so thank you.
But I don't want you to act. I want you to put yourself into the angel's shoes.
Angels had shoes?
It's a figure of speech. What I mean is...
Oh, wings. You meant wings. You want me to put myself on angels' wings.
What I mean is we are supposed to carry on this great announcement. As you put it, be instant messengers to the world, our neighborhood, our group of friends. Think of it in those terms.
I think you lost me just a little bit there. Oh, but how about I sing just a little bit of Wind Beneath My Wings? Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I
Angel.
Wish I could.
Angel, I want you to stop holding on to what you know and what you're comfortable with. Just surrender and trust that I've got a plan and a purpose for all of this. I know you have doubts. I get it. Dive in.
Okay. I guess I'll just dive in. Joseph, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit, and she shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. For it is through him that he shall save his people from their sins.
That was a really great angel, Angel.
You like it?
It was good.
You like me. You really like me. I can't wait to tell everyone I got the part.
I didn't say that. But I will get back to you very soon. In the meantime, maybe you could put that name of yours to some good use. You're already a messenger with the greatest news ever told.
There I go again, making it all about me. My bad, my bad.
Is this the casting call?
It is. You're in the right place.
Good. I thought I was. My name is George Clooney. Not the actor George Clooney, even though we both look a lot alike. I know what you're going to ask. Are you two related? I don't know yet. Check in that out on familytree.com. We will see.
Welcome, George. So, are you here to audition for the live nativity scene this year?
I am, and very excited about this. I think if you allowed me to be a part of this production, I think I could really add a lot to it.
Great. So which character are you auditioning for?
Well, I was looking over the script, and it seems like the character is in the play, but just not in the nativity. And I'd like to see if we could add him in this year.
So you want to audition for a character that's not even in the live nativity?
Correct. You are so easy to talk to. It's true what people say about you. If you allowed my idea to be a part of the story, I think I could really chew up the scenery. Help me help you.
Okay, so which character are we talking about here?
King Herod.
Herod?
I know, right? You're feeling, aren't you? Where's Herod? You've been wondering the same thing. It's okay. Give it a minute. Let it wash over you.
Wondering what?
Why did King Denim make a little cameo in the live nativity? He's the one that got the whole thing started with the census. Why is he left out?
Because he's the bad guy in the story.
Exactly. Every great story has a villain. Darth Vader, gas prices, Bill Clinton. Let's put Herod right in the middle of all of it.
He sends the wise men to go and check things out for him.
Oh, that's right. I guess that's why you're the director. How about this? He's one of the wise men, then boom goes the dynamite. There he is, laughing at that mean, maniacal King Herod laugh. I got you this time, my pretty, and your little drummer boy, too.
I think you just quoted a spy movie and Wizard of Oz all at the same time.
That's what I'm talking about. Let's change up the greatest story ever told.
He wanted to kill Jesus. He wanted to kill all the male babies around so that he would still be the king. He even tried to outsmart God.
Yes, and he almost did too.
But he didn't, not even close. Why don't you just pick a character that was an actual eyewitness to the greatest story ever told?
I don't want to. All the characters that were there, actually on the scene, were poor, dirty, and no flashy clothes. That's no fun.
That's the only way it can work.
No.
George.
I want to do it my way. My idea is a great idea. Let's change the story, my story.
See, that's where you and so many people get it wrong. It's not your story, it's his story. Sorry, the script isn't about you. I'd love for you to play a part in the story, but when you've made it about you and your ideas, we lose sight of why we even celebrate the greatest story.
Okay, I see what you're saying. My ego is not my amigo. I guess I'll audition for the shepherd. He saw an angel and carries a big stick.
Sure.
Great. How about this? He isn't a wise man after all, but a time traveler, and gets transported to 8th century BC, where he knows all this stuff and saves the whole world from destruction and despair.
That's what Jesus did. Next. I'm ready to see people who want to audition for Mary. Next.
Yeah. Hey, I'm here.
So you're here to audition?
Yes, I'm here to play Mary.
You mean you have to audition?
Okay, what's that?
Audition means you read the script and I see if you're right to play the role of Mary.
Oh, I thought if I just showed up, I got the part.
No, it doesn't work that way. Tell me, why do you want to audition?
Well, that's funny.
Excuse me.
Okay, ready.
Let's start with why you want to audition.
My mom made me. She said it would be good for my personality. I think I have an awesome personality.
Well, Mary was the mother of the Son of God. She had a lot on her mind. She had an angel talk to her that set her life on a whole new course.
Yeah, that's cool. She was also worshipped. That's cool, too. I would like to be worshipped. My mom didn't think of that. I did. That's why I have such an awesome personality.
It wasn't about Mary. It's about the child she carried that we worship. Huge difference.
Okay, look, Mr. Director, do I have to say anything? Can I just kneel and look at the baby Jesus? I can do that. That's good, right? Oh, and I can also look to Joseph and then back to the baby Jesus. So, do I get it?
I don't think you do get it, I mean. On so many levels. So, let's try this. Pick up the Bible and read Luke chapter 1, verse 46 through 49.
My mom did not say I would have to read. And Mary said, my soul magnifies the Lord, my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked upon the humble estate of his servant. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed, for he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah, way cool.
I'm sorry, what are you doing?
I'm Facebooking and tweeting this really cool moment I'm having to my followers.
You have 49 followers, and two of them are your grandparents who don't even know how to use Twitter. Look, I see how hard it is for you and even adults to believe that it's not all about you. In a sense, we all worship something other than God. You know, the place you pour out all your best energies, the thing that defines who you are, the thing you absolutely can't live without, the kind of God that will die if not plugged into the wall at night.
Ouch. True. Guilty. Okay, I want to do this. I want to play Mary and look longingly at baby Jesus.
I think I have another part for you. It's not a flashy role or even a role that would warrant a lot of tweets, but it could be the greatest role of your life.
The greatest role of my life? I'll do it.
I haven't even told you what the role is yet.
I don't care. I'll do it.
Are you sure?
Totally. What is it?
Props. You'll be in charge of the manger scene.
What?
We're now ready to hear auditions for the role of Joseph.
Hi, I'm Joe. Joe Stahelman.
Hi, Joe. Could you adjust your microphone for me just a little bit? Bring it down. There you go.
Is that better?
That's much better.
Okay, good.
Why are you auditioning for the role of Joseph today?
Well, in all honesty, pound for pound, my wife made me.
So this isn't something you volunteered for on your own?
No.
Say it ain't so, Joe.
Can't. Wish I could, but my wife says I'm kind of a caveman. Says I sit at home watching a little bit too much SportsCenter. Says I care way too much about watching NASCAR and hillbilly hand fishing than giving back to the body of Christ.
I see. Well, Joseph is a big role, the earthly father of the Messiah who trekked a trail from their hometown to Bethlehem on foot, over 300 miles to register for a census. He married a woman that was pregnant with the Son of God. That's some big shoes to fill.
Yeah, about that, I probably should have auditioned as a shepherd or something, because all they really do is watch sheep and keep to themselves. Once again, my wife's idea, not mine, because that's my full name, Joseph. Joseph Arlene Stahelman.
Arlene?
Yeah, my mama was a twin. That was my aunt's name. I was the youngest of three boys and no girls, so got the middle name Arlene. I know, it's embarrassing, humiliating, makes you want to run and head for the hills every time your mama gets angry. Joseph Arlene Stahelman, you put that cat down. God did not put that cat on this earth in order for you to make a boomerang out of him. You know, mama was always very sensitive towards the feline community.
Someone definitely needed to be. You actually might be perfect for the role of Joseph, Joe.
You know, I reckon I ain't seeing what you're seeing.
Here's the deal. All the emotions you're feeling, the confusion, the embarrassment, humiliation, disillusionment, Joseph felt all of those.
Hold on. I've seen that live nativity scene. Joseph always looked so happy looking down at baby Jesus. See, ain't none of those emotions in that manger.
How do you think Joseph got to that moment? What do you think were the emotions going on in his heart, soul, and mind when the angel delivered the news that Mary would be with a child carrying the Son of God?
I was kind of reckoning he was said, okay, and was fine with it.
As you would say, pound for pound, it was probably a major blow to his world. He had to decide whether to follow what the angel Gabriel told him, as crazy as it sounded, or do what was best for him.
I guess I've always kind of lived that way. Always been a live and let live kind of guy.
It's definitely easier to be that way, but think about what it says in Matthew. The angel Gabriel told Joseph, I stand in the presence of God, and I was sent to speak to you and to bring you this good news. Do you think it was good news to him at first? Or did he have to wrestle with it and what everyone else would think?
I reckon in some ways it was not his will be done, but God's will.
Exactly.
Kind of like my situation. Not my will be done, but my wife's.
Now we've gotten off track. Speaking of a union, Joseph, after hearing the news and being a righteous man, wanted to divorce Mary quietly so it wouldn't be brought out in public. See, back then, even during an engagement, it took two witnesses to legally get a divorce. He thought Mary was unfaithful. It wasn't until the angel said to marry her and take her home that Joseph followed.
You know, I reckon if Joseph was feeling all those feelings and having all those emotions, maybe I am right for this part. You know what? Put me in, coach. I'm ready to play.
I think you are. I think you nailed your audition with the simple realization that it's not your will, but God's. His son would say the same exact thing 33 years later as he died for the sins of the world.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy you did that for me. I'll try thinking about that next time looking at little baby Jesus. Guess that's what you theater folks call getting into character.
Something like that.
One more thing. Do I have to wear the whole biblical robe thingy?
You do.
Are you sure? I can wear my camel hunting pants. It's kind of like wearing a robe.
Sorry, not your will.
I know.
Joe?
Yes, sir?
Give me that Joseph pose one more time.
Yeah, pound for pound.
We're now auditioning for the wise men. Who's next?
That would be me.
Welcome. Oh, wait, what are you doing?
Well, that's my wise man pose, you know, for the audition.
You don't need to do that quite yet. Let's start with your name. I see here it's Frank Cosgrove.
Frank Cosgrove. Cos like cosmic and grove like orchard.
Is that Irish?
Indeed.
Do you speak Irish?
Well, no. Is that a requirement of the part? Did one of the wise men come from Ireland on a camel? Was it even called Ireland then? Yeah, I thought they all I would have to do was bow and present a present to the baby Jesus.
No, you're fine. I was just trying to spark up some conversation.
Oh, I'm not good with people.
Really? Never would have guessed that.
That's why I thought the part would be perfect for me. No talking, no interacting with anyone, just bow, hands 3 inches off the ground, presenting the gift to the baby Jesus.
That is a good kneel, for sure.
Darn tootin'. The other reason I thought it'd be perfect is because I'm very smart. I always have been. Smart and wise are basically the same thing.
They're really not, though.
No? Well, nonetheless, I've seen the efforts of lesser earthlings to play this part in the past, and I think it should really go to me.
Did you just call humans earthlings?
I'm not good with people.
Uh-huh. Well, there is a line that we've taken from the Bible and scripted for the wise man. Do you mind picking up the script and reading wise man number one, please?
Okay. Wise man one, I had a dream that we must not return to Herod. We must go back to our own country another way.
Okay, thank you. Next.
Wait, that is illogical, Captain.
Pardon me?
I nailed that reading. Wasn't expecting to read, but still, there should be no next. There should be just welcome to the live nativity squad. Where's my beard and robe?
I appreciate your enthusiasm. Sorry, what are you doing on your phone?
I'm Googling Magi. Magi means great. That audition was great. You casting me in this part would be tantamount to Peter Jackson putting Sir Ian McKellen in the role of Gandalf in Lord of the Rings.
The wise men wanted to worship him. You are worshiping yourself. You need to do some more seeking before you can play the wise man.
The wise man sought and found the Christ child. Now they should go back to Herod and report what they found. That's the smart thing to do. Stay out of trouble.
Smart thing, sure, but definitely not the wisest option. See, they saw the Christ child. It changed them. They followed the star, and what started out as a mission for a king became null and void when they met their true king.
Look, the wise man traveled 1,000 miles with very little information to find the baby. I, too, have traveled a long way for this audition.
Your audition sheet says you live 5 blocks away from the church.
Playing hardball, I see. Maybe I could give you a gift. Let's see, I have some jelly beans, yellow in nature, not unlike gold. You could have my driver's license. It says Frank, so it's Frank in a sense. Myrrh. I don't know what I'd even begin to give you for myrrh. It's a weird word. Sounds like a constipated cow. Myrrh.
I am not the one that you should be offering gifts to. Let me try and help you out. Pick up the Bible and read what it says about the wise men, as far as their character.
Okay. They, having heard the king, went their way, and behold, the star, which they saw in the east, went before them until it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy.
See, you're not ready to play a wise man until you don't have anything else run your life. No logic or feelings, but simply Christ. Don't miss what's really important. See, for everyone else in the nativity, nothing else mattered but what arrived that night, so that's what truly makes you wise.
My turtle! My turtle's name is Myrtle. Like myrrh. I knew I couldn't be outsmarted.
You named your turtle Myrtle?
No, don't be silly. I named my turtle Yertle, you know, like the book. But then Yertle laid an egg, so I had to change Yertle's name to Myrtle. I'm not good with people.
We are ready to cast the part of Mary. Who's next?
Hi, I'm Connie, which is so opposite of Mary. Connie. I was named after my aunt. Such a hard name. Mary's such a sweet, soft name.
You're fine. Thanks for taking the time out and coming to audition today. I see here you want to portray the role of Mary in the live nativity?
Sorry. Hello? Hi, honey. I'm auditioning for Mary in the live nativity. There's lasagna in the fridge. It's on the top shelf of the fridge. Well, did you move anything? Put our daughter on the phone. Hi, sweetie. Can you help Daddy find the lasagna in the... Yeah, top of the... Oh. Can you put Dad back on the phone? Hi, honey. Sounds like the girls ate it while they were over last night. Yeah, so you'll have to order pizza. I know, so disappointing. All right, enjoy. Bye. So sorry. My world just never stops.
It's totally okay. You actually have a lot in common with Mary. Her world didn't stop either.
Which just makes it even more perfect. I've seen the live nativity lots of times, and I just thought, why not? I can stand there and hold a baby. Heavens knows, I have 3.
Great. Are you ready to read some lines for Mary?
She has lines? I mean, I didn't think she had lines. I've always just seen her stand there and look longingly at baby Jesus, and then every once in a while, up at Joseph, and then Mary does the back and forth. Jesus to Joseph. Joseph to Jesus. See? I can do that.
But no reading lines?
She's Mary. She's the mom of the Son of God. I wouldn't even know what she sounds like.
I assure you, the lines are straight from the Bible. It makes our script.
Yeah, but...
What?
Well, I've read the script, or Bible, and... Luke 1:30. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God."
Yes, and?
Well, I don't know if I've found favor with God. I'd hate for my words or my life to misrepresent what took place that day. But I can pose and look longingly at Jesus.
I hear what you're saying, Connie. And really, that's what we should all be doing this holiday and every day.
It's my mom. She hasn't been doing so well. Can I just for a minute? Hi, Mom. I'm in the middle of auditioning for Mary for the live nativity. Yes, the Virgin Mary. Yes, Mom, I'm aware of that. Sure. I can come over right after this. No, it's fine. They're having pizza, so we're okay. You'll have to tell me who is on Fox News when I get over there. Okay. I love you too. Well, I really botched this audition. I'll just get my things.
Actually, I think the part of Mary would be perfect for you. Just as Mary had doubts and questioned the angel saying, "How can this be?" I see you have doubts too. See, Mary was favored. That means she was gracious, caring, considerate, freely giving of her love. I think you embody that totally.
Oh, wow. I don't feel any of those things. As a mom and a wife, I just feel like I'm always gripey and yelling and trying to stay one step ahead of everything and just always feeling like I'm failing.
Do me a favor and read Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 38.
Okay. In the 6th month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at this saying, and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your relative Elizabeth in her old age has also conceived a son,
And this is the sixth month with her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible with God. And Mary said, Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word. And the angel departed from her.
So what do you think?
I don't know. The angel said she was highly favored. I'm just me.
Connie, you're his child too. See, your name is beautiful to the creator of the universe.
It seems impossible.
But you just read that nothing is impossible for God. You'll do great, Connie.
Yeah. Hey, I like the way you said my name. I can't wait to be in this play. Maybe even if just for one night, my world will spin a little slower. Maybe I can just stand there and look at Jesus.
You don't have to wait.
Well, as a wise woman once said, may it be unto me according to your word.
Little one who was born. Let me tell you a story. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in the manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. How fitting it is that you were born amongst this mess, in a barn full of animals and hay, in an unsafe, fallen world. No palace to shield you from the world, but a full view of humanity, from a barn, no less. As you grow, your story will become the greatest story that will be told for centuries from one generation to the next. Nations will be divided because of your birth. Calendars will be divided in light of your birth. The world, in all its busyness, won't recognize you at first, but some will realize a Savior entered the world. You will see the hurt, the anger, the pride, every hidden shame and frailty, and yet, you will still love. You will see true worship, and you will see some run to empty wells for a quick fix. And yet, you will still love. When people read about you, they won't see a king's way of life. But you will be called the King of Kings. A king's crown was not bestowed on you, but you will die with a crown of thorns on your head as you give your life so that they may have an eternal one, a real life. Yes, you will hear the words, This is my son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased. Pleased I am. So fitting that the Son of God is born in a manger, amongst the mess, the world's mess. You will hear their cries and weep for them. You will hear their prayers and heal them. You will die a cruel death and rise again for them. Some will see that though the thief comes to kill, steal, and destroy you, you, my son, came to give them life. Just as the prophet foretold, little one, the Lord will give you a sign. The virgin will give birth to a son, and we will call his name Emmanuel. God is with us. Please stand and join us.
All is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child. Holy infant, so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
Well, as we close this morning, we thank you for joining us for the greatest message ever given. Amen? That's right. And we want to invite you back the next two Sundays, 10 o'clock. We're going to dive in to this story in the Gospel of Luke as we look in this most important message ever given. So next Sunday, we'd love to have you back 10 o'clock. December the 23rd, we'd love to have you back at 10 o'clock. And then again on Christmas Eve at 6 p.m., we are going to have a small family Christmas together again out of the Gospel of Luke. We'd love to have you join us. There's going to be some refreshments out in the lobby. Enjoy your fellowship time. We look forward to seeing you again. Thanks for coming.